Someone else into the service of the Lord. At this time, will we please stand? We're going to go into the prayer and then into the scripture. Father God, we come before you just to say thank you. Thank you for things being as well as they are right now. We ask, Lord God, that you would come into the midst of us, Lord God. Let your presence saturate this place. God, penetrate our hearts, Lord God, that we would go, Lord God, from this place, Lord God, with a new beginning, with a new lease on life. Lord, we pray for peace. We pray for healing. We pray for comfort to those that are suffering right now, God. And we pray, Lord God, that you would give us direction, Lord God, in the days ahead. Lord God, we pray that you would touch the speaker on today. Let the word of God go out, Lord God, and not return void, God, but let it accomplish all that you send it out to do. And we'll forever give you praise, glory, and honor. In Jesus' name, amen. We're going to go right into the scripture, Psalms 96, 1 through 3. Let us read. Oh, sing unto the Lord a new song. Sing unto the Lord all the earth. Sing unto the Lord, bless his name. Show forth his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the heathen, his wonders among all people. We're going to introduce the praise team under direction of Elder Philip Blessing.
Tell your neighbors, good to see you. How many of you know nothing can wash away my sin but the blood? What can wash away my sin? We say,
nothing but the blood of Jesus.
It's a birthday, come on. And what can make me whole again? Come on.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Oh, precious is that flow.
name of Jesus, the mighty name of Jesus, Satan,
all you have to flee.
Oh.
Tell me, who can stand before us?
When we call on that name,
call on that name,
his name is Jesus,
Jesus, precious Jesus, we have the victory.
Put your hands together, come on, right here. Oh, it's through the blood of Jesus, through the blood of Jesus, we have the victory. Oh, yes, through the blood of Jesus, through the blood of Jesus, Satan will have to flee.
Oh, tell me, who can stand before us when we call on that
His name is the mighty name of Jesus, we have the victory. Let's put the name in, come on.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus,
say that we have the
victory. You have to believe.
Oh,
tell me, who can stand before us when we call on that name?
His name is
Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus.
Oh. Through the blood of Jesus, it's through the blood of Jesus, we have the victory. Everybody, everybody say,
through the blood of Jesus,
through that blood,
through the blood of Jesus, say now you have to flee.
Oh, oh, oh,
tell me, who can be
like a car when we call on that great name? What's his name?
Jesus, Jesus, precious.
Oh,
we are the victory.
Oh, what a mighty God we serve. Everybody sing it.
What a mighty God.
Listen, congregation, you know the
angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him.
What a mighty God.
What a mighty God we serve.
What a righteous God.
What a mighty God we serve.
What a righteous God.
Heaven and earth adore.
What a righteous,
what a mighty God.
One more time. What a mighty God.
What a mighty God we serve.
What a mighty God.
What a mighty God we serve.
You know the
angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God.
Now you know he's a mighty God. Put your hands together. It's a birthday celebration. Yeah. Come on. You tune it live. Come on. We celebrate. Yeah. One more time. One more time. What a holy God.
What a holy God we serve.
What a holy God.
What a holy God we serve.
You know the
angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore.
What a holy,
what a holy God.
Some praise. Well, how many of you are glad to be in the house of God? One more time, tell your neighbors that things are changing. What you're going through, it won't be this way always. It won't be like this all the time. It won't be this way. I was thinking last Sunday, going on there seeing what happened across the street behind us, killing going on. Everybody dealing with stuff.
and that song came to my mind. It won't be this way always. It's a congregation of everybody. There will be
a brighter day.
You tune in live. God's gone. God's gone to wipe all your tears. Somebody wave your hand and say, it won't be this way always. Not always. Somebody lift your hand right there and worship him. Not always. No more shooting, no more killing. Not always. No more heartache and pain. Not always, Bishop, not always. No more suffering, no. Somebody ought to wave your hand and say, not always. You tune it out. It ain't gonna hurt like that no more. He's gonna wipe your tears away.
Not always.
I come to tell somebody need to hear. Not always. I want you to know it won't be the way. Trouble, not always. Woo, I got 2 minutes. Disappointment. Not always. Somebody need to wave your hand and say, I feel that feeling. It won't be this way. It won't be this way.
Always.
There will be
a brighter day.
God's gonna wipe one better. Stand on your feet and thank God things are changing. Hallelujah. Ooh, I was praying this morning. God said he's doing something special for you, Woodbury. Not always. It ain't gonna hurt no more. He's gonna do something special.
Not always.
Tell your neighbor, say, it ain't gonna be like that. It's gonna change, yes, it.
Not always.
God bless you, praise team. It ain't gonna hurt no more shooting. Put down your knife, put down your gun. Not always. Last Sunday, mama was crying so hard she couldn't hardly breathe. The pain was hurting her so bad, she couldn't describe. She couldn't open her eyes and look at Bishop. She just was hollering, just hollering. I left that. I said, oh, God, put down the guns. It won't be this way. Not always. It ain't going to be this way. That's what I told Mama. Don't hurt yourself, Mama. It ain't going to be. Not always. Look at your neighbor and give God a hand praise and say, it ain't going to be like this always. See, so I'm kidding. I think it's birthday time in Woodbury. What about you? Don't he look good? You grew in life. Don't he look good? Don't he? It's a poor frog. I stole Sister Paul's slogan. We thank God for our bishop, don't we? Let's do it. Happy birthday. Happy C-Sharp. Happy birthday to you. Evan, that's it. Real loud. Happy birthday, Bishop Daniel. Come on. That's our bishop, ain't it? Ain't that our bishop? Let's thank God for the elect first lady is with him. Thank God. As young folks will say, them our people. Them our folks right now. You know, them our kinfolk. Look at your neighbor and say, we look just like one another. We is all one big family. Ain't that right? We want the WMFC choir to get prepared to start coming as Pastor Parks is coming with the announcement. And after she get done, choir members, you can start coming up. We receive Pastor Weaver. Let's thank God for Pastor Paul.
Come on, bless the Lord in his house. I said, come on and bless the Lord in his house. Amen. The song say it won't be this way. Tell your neighbor, say, not always. What you're dealing with right now, not always. It may not make no sense to you right now, but tell your neighbor, say, when it's over. When it's over, amen. You can't make no sense out of your situation now, but when it's over, glory to God. The storm gonna pass over. The storm didn't come to last. I said the storm didn't come to last, but the storm came to pass. Tell your neighbor, say it's passing. We just bless the Lord for being back in the house of the Lord. We appreciate God this morning, amen. We honor the Lord, amen, for being back in the presence of the Lord, amen. Being able to celebrate this morning, amen. Our bishop, amen, and first lady right by his side, amen. Birthday celebration. Come on, let's give it to him, amen. We thank God. Amen. For being a part of a celebration. Amen. I want to say amen that Tuesday is our church fast day. Bible study at 7 o'clock p.m. over in Lucia Wood Fellowship Hall. And as Brother Phil said, amen, the choir, you have to come up, amen, when they get finished. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Come up. Amen. We thank God for you all. We just thank God for just being back in his presence. And want you to be praying. Amen. Pray one for another. You never know when somebody has to come alongside of you. Amen. And hold you up and bear you up in prayer. And sometimes that's all you can do sometimes. Amen. But we just thank God. Amen. We appreciate him for being back in the presence of the Lord. Amen. God bless you this morning.
Worthy of all of the praise, all of the honor, it belongs to the Lord. Amen. Happy birthday to my bishop, and God bless my first lady. We certainly thank God for you. Amen. This evening we'll have two offerings this evening. One, this first offering is our church tithe and offering. And then the second offering will be for our bishop's birthday. After the word of God, then prepare to sow into this great man of God's life. There ought to be a happy time to. This is your opportunity to be blessed. Malachi 3 and 8 say, will a man rob God? But you say, wherein have we robbed thee? In tithes and offering. Bring ye all the tithes to the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house, and prove me. Herewith says the Lord of hosts, if I would not open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that you would not have room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake, and all nations shall call you blessed. We're going to ask our deacons if they would come. Let's receive our offering. God is so good. Amen. God is awesome. Amen. Give, and it shall be given unto you. Pressed down, shaken together, running over with good measure. Shall men give unto your bosom. It is the liberal soul that shall be made fat. Amen. Bow your heads with me. Kind Heavenly Father, we thank you for this offering. We thank you for those that are sowing in this ministry. God, we know that they are going to receive a harvest for the seeds that they're sowing in this ministry. Bless their businesses. Bless them in their endeavors of getting an education. Bless the college kids in the name of Jesus. We know that you're able. We know that you can, Lord. Make a way, Lord, where there seemed to be no way. Oh, God, open a door for somebody that needs a door to be opened. Oh, God, and you will close one if one needs to be closed. Close that door. Oh God, and open up a window of opportunity. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. I'd like to say that there are a couple of ways that you can give here at WMFC. You can give through our online banking, bank to bank. Say I live a ways away and you're hearing us online. You can do bank to bank with United Bank. Also, you can mail that offering in at P.O. Box 511, Woodbury, Georgia. And we'll certainly be so grateful that you sowed into this ministry. And watch God bless your life. I say all the time, everything can turn on a dime. It can change on a dime. Just one dime, man. And God will bless your life. God bless you.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Do we have any happy saints in here today? All right. We see you, Pastor. Y'all remember Pastor? I can't get the last name. She married now. That's her husband with her and her children, some of her church members. Come on, let's praise the Lord for one of our own. Amen. We was gonna do two songs, but according to the time, we want to give the man of God enough time to preach the choir. Gonna do one song, Come Thou Almighty King. How many want the Lord to come? As I've always stated, he's already here, amen. We want to thank God for our bishop, our first lady. Woo! And that girl sharp. That girl sharp. She pointing at her husband. And Bishop sharp. Amen. Come thou almighty King.
Come thou mighty King, come join your might.
From the Lord. We have a young man here this morning that loves the Lord. No doubt about it. Brought up in the fear of God. Brought up in holiness. Know the plan that God has for his life. And prophetically, we speak over his life. He is a leader. He's a daddy. He's a husband. He is our bishop firstborn and co-pastor, Dr. Daniel. Will you rest on your feet and let's receive this man of God. How many ready for a word? Somebody shout, preach, Elder Jeff. Really, his title is Pastor Jeff. He did have a church for the epidemic hit, so it's Pastor Jeffery Benoit. Daniel, come on and say, preach, Jeff.
Amen. Come on, let's give God a hand clap. Amen. Let's do a little bit of this holy, 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 holy. Lord God Almighty, God in three persons. Hallelujah. Y'all just sang it with us. Holy, holy, holy Lord God Almighty. God in three persons. Oh, blessed Trinity. The Lord is holy, 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 merciful and mighty God in three persons. Oh, blessed Trinity. Come on and clap those hands and thank God. Amen. How many are happy to be in the house of the Lord today? Amen. How many need a word from God today? Amen. We certainly thank God for who he is and what he has done. Amen. We thank God for, amen, my mentor, my friend, my leader, my pastor, my dad. I thank God for him. Come on, let's give Bishop Daniels a hand clap. First Lady Daniels, come on, let's give it up for them. Amen. I'm just so excited to be in the house of the Lord. I only have a few minutes, so I'm just going to say a few things and get out of here. Amen. If you don't mind, let's get to the Word of God. Let's go to Exodus chapter 1. I thank God for my family. Amen. My sons being here today. Thank God for my wife. Amen. Come on, let's give her a hand. Amen. Amen. There is a word from the Lord today. Exodus chapter 1. Amen. We're going to read some scriptures. It says, "Now these are the names of the children of Israel which came into Egypt. Every man and his household came with Jacob, Reuben, Simeon, Levi, and Judah, Issachar, Zebulun, and Benjamin, Dan, and Naphtali, Gad, and Asher, and all the souls that came out of the loins of Jacob was 70 souls." Everybody say 70 souls. "For Joseph was in Egypt already." Amen. And the sixth verse says, "And Joseph died, and all his brethren and all that generation, they passed along." Amen. And it says, "And the children of Israel were fruitful and increased abundantly." Everybody say abundantly. "And they multiplied and waxed exceedingly mighty." Key thing here, they say they were fruitful. The Bible says be fruitful and multiply. The only way we can multiply is to be fruitful and do the will of the Lord. And it says here, "They were fruitful and increased abundantly and multiplied and waxed exceedingly mighty. And the land was filled with them." So the land was filled with the descendants that was left here after Joseph went on. Then the eighth verse says, "And there arose a new king," say a new king, "over Egypt, which knew not Joseph." Didn't know who he was, didn't know his name. Someone else came to the scene with an agenda. How many know that the enemy will bring things your way and try to set up plots and snares for you? But when you were child of the king, no weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper. So here a new king comes along. "And he rose, and he said unto his people, Behold, the people of the children of Israel are more and mightier than we." He said, they're more and mightier than we are. So here we have a new king coming to the scene, intimidated by what God has set in place. So how many know that when God sets something in place, there's nothing the devil can do to stop what God has in store? So here the plan of God was already in place, but a new king comes and tries to decipher what God has put in place. The ninth verse says, "And he said to his people, Behold, the children of Israel are more and mightier than we. Come on, let us deal wisely with them. Let us set up traps and snares so we can get them out of the way." That's what he's saying here. "And so when it came to pass, when there falleth out any war, they would join also unto our enemies and fight against us. So get them up out of the land." So here they're plotting and trapping and setting up traps. "Therefore, they did set them taskmasters." Now, taskmasters is something that comes when they come to give you a task that they feel that it is impossible for you to do, or give you something to set you up for failure. So that's what the enemy does. He'll send somebody to set up traps and set things up and set you up to fall. See, that's what haters do. Haters put things around you and set you up to fall so they can take your place. So here, this is what was going on. They were setting up traps and snares to afflict the children of Israel. And then it says here, the taskmasters came to afflict them with their burdens. And they built for Pharaoh treasure cities, Pithom and Rameses. These are just cities that were set up to destroy. They were vicious cities. And the 12th verse says this, but the more they afflicted them, see that but there, that's a conjunction. It says, but the more they afflicted them, the more they multiplied and grew. See, sometimes the more your enemy throws up trap, God is setting up doors for you to walk in. That's why we can't wait and see what the enemy is doing. We have to know that if God be on my side, he's worth more than the world's against me, and no weapon that is formed against me shall be able to prosper. And if God be for me, he's worth more than the world against me. So here he says here, they afflicted them, and the more they afflicted them, the more they multiplied and grew. And they, here's what happened. The new people, they were grieved because of the children of Israel. They were grieved. The children, they didn't have to do anything. All they had to do was stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. And that's all he wants us to do, is stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Amen. Let's go to 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians. Amen. 4 and 7. 2 Corinthians 4 and 7. Amen. It says this, but we have this treasure. Everybody say treasure. Treasure is something that you value very, very dearly, something you take to your heart, something you have it's valuable to you. The Bible says wherever your heart is, that's where your treasure is. Also, it says, but we have this treasure in earthly vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. So we understand here that the power comes from God. We're only able to do certain things, but with God, we can do all things through Christ that gives us the strength. With God, we can conquer all things. With God, you have dominion over the earth. With God, you're the head and not the tail. You're above and not the leaf. You're the lender and not the borrower. With God, you can decree a thing, and it shall become established unto thee, because he gave us the authority to speak his word. He says, speak his word. Amen. It says, we are troubled on every side. How many are going through trouble today? How many are going through situations in your life today? Amen. We're going to be troubled on every side. That's part of life. Everything is not going to go the way we want to go. But one thing we have to understand is the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and they that dwell therein. So we're dwelling in the land of God. So he's in control. Whatever you need is nothing to God, because he owns everything. When you go to the master, you have access to what the master owns. He is the master, not your boss, not the opportunity, not the vision that you have, but he is the master. Matthew 6:33 said, if you seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, what did he say? Everything you need will be added to you. Seek God. We don't seek the things, we seek God, because he owns everything. He says, but with this treasure in earthly vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus Christ. He died for our sins. So whatever you're going through today, know that he has it all in his plans. Whatever you're facing today, know that it's in the will of God. Whatever you see today, know that God is working things out for your good. Sometimes the bad works for your good.
Sometimes things you don't agree with work for your good. Sometimes a no work for your good. Because God knows the end before the beginning. So we have to trust him at all times. Philippians 4:19 says, my God will supply all of your needs. Not just one of your needs. Not just two of your needs. He says, I will supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory. So we're not to get perplexed, or we're not to get despair, or we can get persecuted, but not forsaken. Not forsaken. Down, cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body of the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also Jesus might be made manifest in our bodies. So his word has to be manifested in our bodies. The word of God has to be made alive in our bodies. This book has to be made in our bodies. That's what he's saying. Because he came down, he died so that we could be free. He died so that we can have the right to eternal life. He died that you could be prosperous. He died that we could be who we wanted to be. He died for you. He died for me. He died for all of us. And so that's why we can say, no weapon formed against thee shall prosper. Every time I think of the goodness of Jesus and everything he's done for me, my soul get happy. I may not have everything I want, but I know that he's going to supply everything that I need. I may not be where I need, where I want to be right now, but I know that God has my interest at heart. Amen. So today we want to talk about adversity. Amen. If you don't mind, just look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, in the midst of adversity, we are victorious. Amen. Look at another neighbor and say, neighbor, in the midst of adversity, we are victorious. So when you're victorious, that means that you're praising him in advance, because you know the battle is already won. You know that we have already won before we go into the battle. We are victorious. We're the children of the Most High God. He designed for us to be victorious in every situation of our life. When we come into the room, there has to be a change in everything that we do. When we step foot into that job, there needs to be a glow. There needs to be a glow in our lives. Amen. The word victorious, the act of defeating an enemy or opponent in battle. Here's the beautiful thing. We don't even have to go to battle. All we have to do is stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. All we have to do is go to the battle with our praise, and God will destroy your enemies. See, they tried to take down the children of Israel. They tried to take down Daniel in the lion's den. But Daniel prayed to his God. The Bible says he prayed 3 times a day. That's before they even came to him. He prayed to his God, and he told them, he says, I know my God will deliver me. He said, I know my God will deliver me. And so what happened? The angels came into Daniel's room, and they begin to shut the mouth of the lions. See, sometimes you just stand still and let God do what he does. He will shut the mouth of your haters. He will shut the mouth of those that talk against you, because no weapon formed against thee shall be able to prosper. The lions are the most vicious animals in the world. Daniel's sitting in the lion den, saying, I know my God will deliver me out of this situation. I know my God will deliver me out of this test. I see y'all lions around me, but there's a force that's greater than y'all. That where I am, there he is also. And if he's on my side, there's nothing you can do. You can stand there and look all you want to, but my God is going to deliver me out of this lion's den. because I know I'm the head and not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. So what do you got to say, Hebrew boys? We're going into the fire. Nebuchadnezzar said, turn the fire 7 times higher. We're in the middle of the fire. But we know that our God is going to deliver us out of this fiery furnace. It was 3 that came in. But at the end of the day, 4 came out. My God stepped in the fire and delivered the Hebrew boys out of the lion's den, out of the fiery furnace. That same God will step into your life and deliver you out of that situation. Will bring you out of bondage. Will bring you out of prosperity. Will bring you out of that situation. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Come on and give him a praise. See, we have to stop looking at the situation and look at God. Know that God is the author and finisher of our faith. I may be here today. I can be here tomorrow. God's principle does not work like the world. It just don't work. The world system goes by experience. The world system goes by credibility. You can have a 4-year degree and just get the job. And somebody can have 20 years experience and they can't get the job. That's the world system. But God's system is, I'm going to stand on your word. If you said it, that settles it. If you spoke it, I'm going to do it. Because I know your word will not return void. Now, how many of you God has told you to do something in here? How many of you God has ever spoke to your life and said, do this or do that? This message is for you today. Don't look at your situation. Look at God. Let God do what he does. He says, I'm with you in the morning, in the noonday, in the evening. I'm with you at all times. And so when you're with me, I can do all things through Christ that gives thee the strength. Amen. You may have your seats. I got a couple more minutes. Amen. Amen. So, victorious living. There's a couple of things I want to share with you before we go. Amen. Keys to victory. Everybody say key to victory. Number one, we have to know who we are. And we have to know whose we are. So that means that we're victorious. Our name means victory. When you become a child of God, your names mean victory. That means that wherever I go, I'm victorious. You can step into a situation of conflict and be victorious because you have God on your side. You can go to a meeting and come out with a solution because God is with you. God is on your side. And guess what? God says, I'll give you favor with man. So when you operate in God's favor, he will begin to give you favor with man. Amen. Number two, requires faith. Everybody say faith. Now everybody say relentless faith. Faith means I don't see it. I don't have it in the bank. But I know it's going to happen. I don't have it in my pocket, but I know it's going to come to pass. I see this vision. I don't have everything I need naturally for it to happen, but I know God is going to give me the resources to make it happen. When Nehemiah had to rebuild the wall, he didn't have what he needed. When he started the process, he didn't have what he needed. But he started building anyway. See, you got to start the process. You can't still wait. Everybody wait. Well, I'm waiting on God. Well, it's been 30 years. How long are you going to wait? You got to do something. Nehemiah began to scope out the area. And Pastor Morgan knows about this. He begins to lay out the plans.
See, you got the plan. You can't just go up and start throwing stuff up. You got to strategize this thing. You have to lay out the plan before you begin to build. So Nehemiah was the visionary of that plan. And as the plan came together, people started coming together to help him build the walls. That's the same way God would do for you. Once you start moving into the way God called you to be, he will give you favor. He will put people in your life that don't even know your name that will help you get to where he wants you to be. I believe that. How many believe that today? I believe that God can do anything. He's able to make anything happen. And the third one, we must meditate on his word. Joshua 1:8 talks about that. It talks about meditating on his word day and night. It will make your way prosperous and you will have good success. So when you meditate on God's word and you begin to internalize God's word, it becomes a part of your life. So when you speak, you're speaking God's word. It's not only on Sundays. When you're at your job, you have to speak, and God's words will come out of your mouth. Even if you're doing daily business, you have to speak, and the people will recognize the God in you. So we have to operate in that. And then the last one is sowing. Knowing that there is a harvest coming, it's good to be a blessing to somebody else. When you are blessing to somebody else, you're sowing into ground, and you open up doors to where God can step in and change your situation and put you in a better situation. See, kingdom living is more than what you can have. It's more than the car and the house. See, we like to hear that we're going to get a car in 30 days. Oh, I'm getting ready to get my house. You go home and walk around the backyard, and the house is going to be sick. We like to hear those types of prophecies. But see, real prophecy is you got to live right. See, it's more than just the material things. See, it's more than just the material things of this world, but it's your life styles. There's things that you have to accomplish in your life, because God says if you do this, if you're willing and obedient, you will eat the good of the land. So we have to be willing, we have to be obedient, and we shall eat the good of the land. Amen. So tell your neighbor, in the midst of adversity, we have the victory. Come on, tell that neighbor, in the midst of adversity, we have the victory. Amen. Everyone standing on your feet. Amen. Hallelujah. Lift your hands. Hallelujah. We thank God. Amen. For this celebration, we thank God for what he's going to do. Hallelujah. God, is there someone here today that needs a word in their heart? They need a change in their spirit. God, we're asking that you touch that person right now. Where they're standing, God, we know that you have all power in your hands, and there's no greater source than you. And God, we know that you proclaim this day. You proclaimed this time. You proclaimed this opportunity. And we know, God, that you were bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of your peace was upon us. And by your stripes, God, you said in your word that we are healed, God. I decree healing in the sanctuary. I decree victory in the sanctuary. I decree blessings in the sanctuary. Our children will be saved. Our families will be saved. Our kids will be saved in the name of Jesus. And we give you praise for it now, God. Let your Holy Ghost rest on us. God, as we do your will and do your way, we know, God, that you're with us at all times. And we pray that your word continue to be manifested in our lives. And we thank you for what you're going to do. In Jesus' name, everyone shout amen. Everyone shout amen.
All of you that have children in school, put your hands on, if not your child, put your hand on a child. And we're going to ask Elder Jeff to pray over our school kids, that our kids can go to school with all this shooting going on, and they come back home. We're going to ask him to touch your kids, cover them by the blood.
Yes, touch everybody, touch and agree. We're going to touch and agree. Every young person, everybody grab a young person. If you can find a young person that's in school, grab them right now. Father God, in the name of Jesus, in the midst of turmoil, you said that we will have victory. We pray, God, that you touch all of our kids. God, touch them in their bodies, touch their minds, touch their spirits. Help them, God, to be the best that they can be. As we go into this earth, God, we know that everything we do will give you the glory, God. And cover us, God. Cover our children, God. Cover them at the bus stops, God. Cover them in the classrooms, God. Protect them, God, in the name of Jesus. As they go and do your will, God. In Jesus' name, we thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name, amen, amen.
Come on, let's give Elder Jeff a hand. Let's give Elder Jeff a hand. Come on, that's it. Rest on your feet. Well, look at somebody and tell them it's birthday time. I told you some Sundays back that we want to bless this man of God. We want him to be blessed so that he'll say, wow. Ain't nothing like a wow blessing. Amen. So I know you're prepared to give today. We're asking you that if you did not receive a love offering, Sister Debbie will pass the knees out. Who didn't get one? Raise your hand. Over there, Debbie. If you didn't get one, over on the other side, somebody help her. On the other side. If you didn't get a love offering envelope, then you can cash out Bishop. I'm going to say this slow so you can get it. And you that are viewing us and you want to bless the man of God, you can cash out T and B Daniel. T, B, Daniel. It's on the, okay, there it go. That's what I got. I didn't say dollar sign, did I? Uh-huh, you got to have all of that to get in there, right? Amen. And you can text him, you that are listening, you can text him, send him your love offering. So many of you get blessed, listen to the man of God every Sunday, and you can bless this man of God. If you bless the prophet of God, the Bible says you will receive a prophet reward. You can mail it to Woodbury Miracle Fellowship Center Church. So you got so many ways to give. Just go to our website, the Woodbury Miracle Fellowship Center website, and everything is there. And we know that you're going to bless him. How much we asking for? That means you're going to give the baby some money, right? Don't give him that little 10 cent now. Give him some money. Give him some money. Put it in the hand. Teach them how to give, because all they know is how to receive. But teach them how to give. Everybody giving $100 on today. You don't have it, you don't have to go to Bishop or First Lady. If you don't have it and you want to pay it later, they'll take it whenever you bring it. You just let them know what it's for, and you'll be blessed. Amen. Everybody has their, you ready? Y'all ready to bless the man of God? Bishop gonna come down. Bishop and Dr. Daniel. And listen, make sure you keep your mask on when you come around. Hello, don't get so happy. You got to pull your mask out. Keep your mask on. Okay? This side over here where you stand, this will give you a chance. Pull, will you start them from the back and let them come around? This will give you a chance to speak to the man of God. Dr. Daniel, you need a chair? Not right now. Bishop said he got you. Come on, give us some music as they come. You can say hey, you can say hey. You can say you love him, you can say you love him. You can say you love him. Hallelujah. In the middle aisle, starting from the back. Can you come around, starting from the back? Now, Bishop, right in the middle. That's it, start from the back, come around. Y'all could have came down, came, come down. You could have come down. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord. Come on, come on. Come on, you come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on. Let's bless the man with God. All the pastors, all the pastors, all the elders, hold your money for last. Hold your money for last. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Let him know how much you appreciate him. Amen. Love you, Pastor. Praise him. This side up here. Debbie, let him come this way. This way. Ethan. Oh God, bless this altar. Let it be an overflow. Multiply. Oh God, let it do great things. In the name of Jesus. 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 In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, minister. Precious. Come on. Hallelujah. Bishop, your staff. Bishop, the staff behind. Bless you. Come on, let's give the Lord a praise. Come on, let's thank the Lord for the man of God. Let's thank the Lord for the man of God. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Brother Bussey.
Come on, let's thank God for Bishop. We're getting ready to go. We have prepared a photo shoot. A lot of you don't have pictures of Bishop. We'll be taking pictures of Bishop. We want our mothers. I don't know about you in my home. I don't have a picture of Reverend Bowles, Reverend Lucia Woods, Pastor Calhoun. I want a picture of Bishop Daniel in my house. Those that you, ain't he looking good? So we'll be forming pictures. DJ and the brothers out there in the hallway, we want you to get a picture with him. We're asking Bishop the First Lady to leave and go ahead and get set up in the back so it won't take long, First Lady. He want Pastor Mark to come and get that bucket. Okay. Bishop, let's thank God as they exit. They go. I want you to get a picture with your bishop. Don't he look good? First lady ain't gonna let him do it by herself. She gonna be in there too. Some kind of way she getting in there.